Hello, I'm Kyle Osborne from entertainmentordie.com with your EcoPlanet radio movie review. It's one of the best reviewed films of the year so far, but you've probably had a lot of trouble finding it in the theaters. That's because while other films like, say, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes were playing on nearly 4,000 screens last weekend, Snowpiercer was playing on only 356 nationwide. And it's not because it's esoteric or just for the art house crowd. I mean it in the best sense of the word when I say that Snowpiercer is mainstream.
This chaos. 1,000 people in an iron box.
The world has been frozen solid after a treatment to combat global warming worked too well. The only living human beings are those lucky enough to have boarded a special train earlier, one which, true to the film's title, is able to stay on the tracks, moving at a pace that takes it around the globe once per year. Lower class folks live in the rear, where food consists of a protein bar, wait till you find out where the protein comes from, and no hope of ever seeing anything or anyone outside the confines of their dark, dank car. Yes, the train is an allegorical device, but you know what? Forget the messages. You can actually just enjoy this as a film that combines the best elements of both train films and prison films.
Can we control the world?
Chris Evans, you know him from Captain America, is our Jean Valjean on this train, the one who means to lead a revolt and break down the doors that surely lead to a much better life on the other side. But it won't be easy. A car full of hatchet-wielding thugs, just one of many obstacles to be overcome. Tilda Swinton stands out as the liaison between the never-seen but much-revered owner of the train, Mr. Wilford, and the lower class. Swinton brings some levity to the proceedings, wearing crazy prosthetic teeth, which she uses to chew the scenery like a hamster on balsa wood.
Well, Mr. Curtis, we've been watching you. Precisely 74% of you shall die.
I like movies that take place in a confined space because it forces the writer and the director, Korean Bong Joon-ho in this case, to be creative and inventive. The fun is in having your internal question, how the heck is this going to work itself out, answered over the course of 2 hours. One important footnote, you can rent Snowpiercer for about $7, or you can buy it for about $15 on iTunes, but if you can find one of those few area theaters showing it on the big screen, it's worth the effort and the cost.
You too.
Snowpiercer gets 3.5 out of 4 stars. Kyle Osborne from EntertainmentOrDie.com for EcoPlanet Radio.